Welcome boys. Again we are starting another online class for English version class 8. Today we are doing RMST. Last week we have told that we will start chapter 7, that is the ideal biography. Today we will know about Swami Vivekananda. I will try to make you understand the whole life of Swami Vivekananda briefly. So let us start about Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda, whose earlier name was Narendranath. Actually his main name was Narendranath, later on he was renowned as Swami Vivekananda. He took birth on 12th January 1863 in Calcutta. His father Bishwanath Datta was an advocate in Kolkata High Court. And mother Bhuvaneshwari Devi was a religious housewife. He was very courageous, truthful, liberal outlook and kindness to beings. He didn't like the caste system of Hindu religion. Narendra was very scholar during childhood. He passed entrance exam in first division. He passed BA exam in 1884. After this, his father died and he was seeking for a job as his family was facing financial crisis. But by not getting job, becoming helpless, he joined office of attorney to do translation. During that time, a change happened to him that he was thinking about God and asking questions about God to others. But nobody could satisfy his mind. Then once, he had a chance to meet Ramakrishna Paramahamsadev at Kalibari of Dakshineshwar and asked him a question that, did Ramakrishna see God ever? After listening to Ramakrishna's answer, Narendra was satisfied and liked him a lot. He started to meet Ramakrishna very frequently. Then Narendra became a saint after leaving home. He started to visit different state of country and watched the real situation of country's people. He observed that there were prevailed poverty everywhere and amongst the countrymen there were illiteracy and ill education. He was thinking how to rescue the country people and absorbed in meditation on the last rock of Kanyakumarika at the southern end of India. Through meditation, he realized that religion is the vitality of India and country would develop if the people initiated in the religious doctrine. In 1893, he went to Chicago of America to attend a religious convention of world religion and delivered a speech by listening which all people in the convention was astonished and started to praise him. He was adjusted best speaker of the conference by Professor John Henry Wright of Harvard University of America. He was then famous in America and invited to many public meetings. After winning the heart of Americans with his speech on Hindu religion and philosophy, especially of Vedanta, he left for Europe. He traveled through England, France, Italy and made speech over there. He tried to make realize the people that Hindu religion is not only a worship idol, is not only to worship idol, rather it worship to one God through the worships of multiple gods and goddesses. Many people were following after listening his philosophy. Margaret Elizabeth Noble is mentionable amongst them. She was not only following his philosophy but also left her motherland and came to India to initiate by Vivekananda and assume the name Sister Nivedita. After 4 years of world tour, Vivekananda returned back to his own country in 1897, and people welcomed him with great honor. On return to his reception, he urged to his countrymen to fight against injustice, call for unity, truthful is religion, and to be honest and perform rightfully duty is a part of religion. Vivekananda used to say that people from lower caste, the illiterate, the poor, the ignorant, cobblers, sweepers, all are brothers, and serve them is our religion. He used to think to remove the poverty and spread education to them. He used to say that we have to supply food to the hungers and education to the illiterate. The most important teaching of Vivekananda is serving living beings is equal to serving God. Serving the creatures will serve the God. Thus, he said, Bohurupe shommukhe tomari, chari kotha khujiche ishwar, jibe prem kore jei jon, shei jon sebeche ishwar. Being influenced by this ideology, many hermitages, service centers and school colleges in many villages and towns were established. Vivekananda was not only saying his ideology, but he proved his saying by doing also. In 1898, in Kolkata, an epidemic plague was spread out, and he was in Darjeeling that time. He returned to Kolkata immediately and engaged his followers to save the patients. Vivekananda had a strong voice for the development of women and said that women should have equal right to learn on commerce, industry and agriculture. He evaluated girls as symbol of strength. He donated a part of from his earnings received from the honorariums in America for a Hindu widow to the Baranagar Hindu widow ashram. Vivekananda also established Ramakrishna Math at Baranagar at Kolkata to spread preceptor's philosophy. In 1898, he established permanent mot at Velur of Howrah district on the bank of Gangas. Vivekananda was a hard worker, so didn't spend the time without work. For doing so much work and lack of rest, his health broke out in very short time. As a result, this great saint breathed his last at Belur Math in 4th July 1902, leaving the people of India. He left so many good instances and advices for the human beings, following which we can successful and fruitful in life. So boys, that was the biography of Swami Vivekananda. I hope the brief you have realized, briefly discussion. Later on, we will do another biography from your syllabus. Hopefully, that will be beneficial for you. So, that's all for today, boys.